We have spoken to Sadaf Jafar. She, along with SR Dharapuri, were two people who were held by the UP police in custody. Sadaf Jafar narrates her story in custody. And if you listen to her closely, I'm sure there'll be allegations. She's alleging that there are horror stories of police excesses. There'll be allegations that she's connected to the Congress party and thus may not be speaking the truth. But can you ignore allegations of this kind? Let's first understand what exactly has she said. She says that she was arrested in Lucknow for Facebook live session during the CAA protest. She was called Pakistani, was beaten up. I have Sadaf Jafar with me. Sadaf, many thanks for speaking to NDTV. My first question to you is, we have learnt a lot and caught snatches of your conversation about what you went through. Can you tell us in great detail, what exactly happened and what is your allegation against the UP police?
On the 19th, we were protesting just like any other protesters, and we were like, what happened? The stone pelting began and the arson. And then we moved towards a safer area, and we were standing there, and I was doing a Facebook Live. And I could, it was very we were kind of shocked and surprised that the police initially was totally inactive. They weren't exactly trying to catch hold of these stone pelters. And then after things settled down a bit, we decided to go back home just like after any other demonstration. And we were returning and we were picked up by the police. And while we were being taken to the corner of the street, they started beating us up. And then we were cornered and we were put into a circle by the policemen. And they started hitting us with batons. We were made to sit on the ground and they were right on the street we were beaten up. And I could see one of the person who was there with us, a helmet breaking on his head. You know, the helmet broke into three pieces. And he was semi-conscious. Later on, we were put in the police jeep and we were taken to the Hazratganj thana, where the Mahila thana is also there as a part of it. So I was separated from the rest. And then the police officers, the female police officers, as they came inside, they started slapping me. One of them scratched my face and my hand. I covered my face, so she was scratched and she pulled my hair. And they kept calling us Pakistani. They kept calling that, you know, quotes and quotes, khate yahan ki ho, bajate wahan ki ho, yahan pe tumhe kya kami hai. And they kept treating me, after knowing my name, as if I was alien to this country, as if I was an outsider. And the whole thing, probably, you know, what actually dawned upon me for the first time is how my name went against me and the way I was being treated by even the females. Later on, I was expecting that some phone call they would allow so that I could let my family know that I am okay and I'm detained. I am unhurt, because there was so much of stone pelting and arson. My concern was that my family should know that I am okay. They did not allow me. My phone was taken away at the demonstration place only when I was taken into custody. And they did not allow me to make a phone call. And this continued. And then in much later into the night, I was called into one of the police officer's room. The CO called me. And I was thinking at least the human aspect of him would prevail, and I would request him that at least allow me to make one phone call to my children to tell them that I am still okay. But that did not happen. Instead, the moment I crossed the threshold, he started abusing me in the choicest of words. Again, Pakistani was my term that they used, and they said ki kahan se tum logo ko support milta hai yahan pe, tumko kya kya nahi diya hai sarkar ne, kha rahe ho, pi rahe ho, and jis tarah ki, whether the kind of language that they were using, I can't even repeat it now here. Choicest of abuses. And then he told ki 307 laga ke tujhe jail mein sadaunga. And then there was a lady constable which was typing on the computer. He said, 307 mein inka naam 307 bhi lagao. And then he told the female police who was accompanying me to beat me up. So she gave me two tight slaps. Of course, the person was not satisfied with the brutality, so he himself came. Being a man, I was shocked. He pulled my hair. I still have that strand of hair with me. So he pulled my hair and he kicked me in my stomach and on my knee. And then he said, ki tumhari qualification hai kya, kitna padhi ho, kitna janti ho CAA ke bare mein. And then he kept abusing me. And of course, there was no, I was not given that space where I could request him to inform my family. And then it, I understood that they will, unless and until all those acts that they have put against my name, wo sara jab tak nahi ho jayega, tab tak they will not allow anybody to know who I am. I was shocked that it was much later into the night and nobody had come to find out where I was. Actually, people were coming to Hazratganj Thana to find out, but I have used this term now and again since morning that Hazratganj Thana had turned into a black hole. Whoever was coming to find out about us was getting sucked in and getting detained. The whole night, they kept getting people into the Thana. They were picking up random people, I believe. I don't know who they were, and I could hear the shouts and the cries and the beating that went on in the place where males were kept. I was the only female.
Sadaf, that's a lot of detail, I would say. But, you know, who do you think was doing this? Was this sort of the adventurism of the cops there at Hazratganj police station? Was it the bias of the UP police? Or do you think that they were under orders, because to be able to poison each and every cop in the station is a little hard for an administration to do. I want to understand from you, what do you think could have been the motive and who could ideally be responsible for doing what they did to you?
See, the thing is that the people keep giving the call. Had they allowed us, they had already imposed 144. First thing that surprises me most is that how is it possible for people to carry that too when this 144 was already imposed? How is it possible for people to march down for such a long distance carrying so many stones? That quantum of stone and the size of the stone was so big. How was it that the police bandobast failed? So when Yogiji talks about taking a revenge against the protesters, he should first investigate how did the people were allowed, these stone pelters were allowed to carry so much of stone till Parivartan Chowk where this whole thing took place. Unless and until I am telling this, and I am telling this with full responsibility, that I have this strong feeling that it was absolutely staged the way stone pelting took place. Otherwise, how would police allow in such a difficult situation to carry so much stone to that area?
Okay, now that's an allegation.
First, he should look within himself that where he failed instead of questioning us and then randomly picking up people. I have at least I have a family, I have a political background. But imagine the plight of the people, the random people who were shopkeepers, who were waiters, who were randomly picked up, their names were asked. And they were put into the
Sadaf, you narrate this and you make a lot of allegations and you narrate this in great detail. So obviously, this seems to be something that you may have seen and observed. Now, we asked this question to the UP police top cop, the DGP, and he says, let them complain to us and we'll investigate. So will you file a formal complaint, maybe approach the NCW, NHRC?
Absolutely. Yes, absolutely. Because as I told you that I still have a political backing. I have still people tweeting about me. I still have people who are talking about me. There are so many boys out there who are beaten up brutally by police. I have seen their heads absolutely injured with batons, the way they were beaten up. There were stitches. And there is nobody who has come forward to talk about them. You know, in fact, everybody said, are you relieved after coming out of jail? I said, no, I feel guilty that I am out and still there are so many boys out there who are inside that jail. So my fight against the police brutality as well as against CAA will not rest unless it is rolled back. One, two, unless and until each and every person who is there, innocent person who is there in the jail comes out, my fight is not ending and I will not feel relieved. I can still not sleep comfortably in a warm bed when those children are sleeping on the floor in these cold nights.
All right, Sadaf Jafar, many thanks for speaking to NDTV, speaking your mind. Let's hope that whatever you are alleging, there is an investigation in that case.